Live from Philadelphia, this is Good Day.
Sandusky case here. Thanks, Sue. 7:31 now.
So, I mean, obviously everyone's been talking about it as soon as, you know, the verdicts came down. They came down so late. Former Penn State football coach Jerry Sandusky was found guilty on 45 counts. So right now we are talking with Tom Klein. He was attorney for one of those victims in the case.
Victim number 5?
Yes.
Okay, good to see you, Tom.
Nice to see you.
Back after, what, 2.5 weeks or so over there in Centre County?
Back in Philadelphia. Spent a lot of time in Centre County.
That's for sure. Okay, came down Friday night. Your reaction when it came down, surprise or not?
Oh, I wasn't surprised.
No.
There was a mountain of evidence. There was a defense that basically was it was a conspiracy among the prosecutors, the cops, the lawyers, and yes, the media. I mean, it was not something that Amendola was going to sell.
Well, speaking of Amendola, this is new information in this morning. Apparently, he is not going to represent Jerry Sandusky if there is when the appeal happens, because he's going to be a witness, saying that they did not have enough time to prepare for this trial. 7 months, way too fast. People equated it to whiplash. It was going so fast. What do you think of that?
Well, I've watched this from the very beginning. I have a man to represent, so I've seen it all and all the intimate details. And the fact of the matter is there was more discovery given to the defense in this case, I think, than any case that I've seen, at least that I've watched and observed. There is I think little to no chance, zero, that's going to succeed. There was a mountain of evidence that was turned over, and the claim by the defense is, well, we didn't have time enough to get to it. The fact of the matter is there was overwhelming evidence. There were 10 cases here, not one, 10, and there was a conviction on all 10 charges, all 10 cases. So there's no saying that there was something that would have changed this. The chances for appeal, I would say, are literally near zero.
Well, the charge is that everybody in Centre County was just trying to get this darn thing over with so they can go back to playing football and get their reputation back at Penn State.
Well, I will say one thing. I was there at the very end, and there was literally a carnival-like atmosphere on the courthouse steps at the time of the verdict. Having said that, this was a very thoughtful and careful and very educated jury that deliberated for a long, long time.
Do you think 7 months was too fast for them to get this case together? I mean, do you think that's a legitimate argument?
Absolutely not. There is nothing to it. The fact of the matter is the case was tried in a very meticulous fashion. The defense said everything that they wanted to say. They complained bitterly. In fact, they had access not only to the police statements, for example, which is what the defense gets in a criminal case, they had access to the outtapes. That was part of their defense.
Yeah,
that the lawyers said that the lawyer and the prosecutor somehow cooked this up. There was a ton of evidence. I watched every one of these young men testify.
Compelling.
And it was compelling, mm-hmm. Gut-wrenching. I had I represented a young man who was brilliant. These are men who were battered and tarnished at the root of their soul.
Okay, where do we go from here? Could Jerry Sandusky's wife be charged with anything?
Could be. I mean, if you listen to the
evidence.
How
would you prove it?
Well, circumstantially, there is circumstantial evidence that she was in the home when all of this happened. These young men said we were there 50 to 100 times, some of them. Her testimony was literally, well, Jerry went to bed before me, but then she was pressed and she said, but she knew that he went down to tuck the boys in.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, there is a lot of evidence here. She was not very sympathetic.
Okay,
a woman who is self-described as,
yeah,
quote, the Sarge.
I know the Sarge.
How did your victim take the verdict?
Oh, he told me, he and I text messaged, and then we spoke. We couldn't get through at first because of the cell blockage is a problem. He told me he was numb. He was numb when he received the verdict. This was a young man who was leading his life. He has a good job, a good family, a wonderful girlfriend. And this all came to him. He got a knock on the door. Then he found himself in a grand jury room. He found himself in a courtroom. He found himself before the world telling a story of this hurt and pain that occurred when he was a child.
And it all over again. What about Penn State University? Are they going to have, we're going to go have a civil trial, undoubtedly?
Well, undoubtedly, there obviously are claims. I obviously represent one young man. My view of that is that we're going to wait and see the report of the former FBI director, Louis Free. We're going to see what he has
what
to say.
What they knew and when they knew it.
Well, they have promised a full, complete, thorough investigation. They've promised to tell us all. I want to see it. I want to evaluate it. I want to make a determination as to what it,
looks
what
like
it is.
It looks like there are reports that they may want to move quickly with settlements.
Well, they've said that, but there's a process that we have to put into place to investigate it. I'm interested first and foremost in accountability and Penn State accepting responsibility, full and complete. Then we'll talk about settlements. Okay. First, we have to see what they knew, what they did wrong, and we know it's a lot already. Everyone, literally from the janitor to the president of the university, knew that Jerry Sandusky was a risk to children before the young man
sounds
who
like
I represent
you're building
was
a case.
Assaulted.
Sounds
I'm
like you're building,
I'm building
a
case, and why not?
Against
that's my
Penn
job.
State University, and they have a ton of money.
But I want to see them reform, and I want to see change in American institutions.
I'm going to have
colleges.
You back in Philly.
Thank
glad
you.
To be here.
Get back out to the Phillies game. They need you. All right?
I saw the doubleheader, Mike, and it wasn't pretty.
Cover your eyes.